Hi guys, in the last video we have discussed about the AutoCAD interface. If you not watched that video, please click on the I button and watch it first. And in this video I am going to teach you all the modeling tools in AutoCAD 3D. So quickly, let's get started. So the first command I am going to teach you is the extrude command. We have also discussed this command in the previous video. It is very easy. So for that, simply make a profile. I am going to make a rectangle using the line command. Enter a length of 50. And breadth of 50 like this and close it, then press escape. Now use the region command to join all the lines. As I say, you can only convert a 2D diagram to a 3D when all the lines are joined. For that, type region, then select at any point, then select the object, then press enter. Now all the lines are in the same object. Now we can extrude that. Type ext, which is the shortcut of extrude command, then press enter. Now select the object. Now before to extrude that, simply click on this home icon to see the isometric view. Now you can adjust the height. I want a height of 100 units, and here it is. Our first 3D diagram is ready. Now let us discuss about the another command, which is the revolve command. So for that, let's make another profile. So for that, I am going to make a cylindrical object. A revolve command is basically used to produce cylindrical objects. So for that, I am going to make a rectangle like this, having a number of steps. Make number of steps like this. And I think it is enough. So this is the sectional view of a object that I am going to draw. Again, use the region command to join all the lines. Now select the object, then press enter. Now the object is completed. Now revolve this using revolve command. Type REV, which is a shortcut of revolve command. Then press enter. Now select the object first, then press enter. Now for the axis, select this line and this point. Now select this home icon to see the isometric view. Now we can revolve this up to 360 degree time. So I am going to type 360. Now the profile is completed. To see it more clearly, I am going to change the view to shaded with edges. Now change the view to this direction. Now here it is. You can see how beautifully I used the revolve command to produce a component like this. Now let's see what is the another command we have to learn. This is the loft command. Let me teach you. First, change the view to the top view and change the view to 2D wireframe. Now the loft command is something when you want two different profiles and join them like this. Up two or three, you can choose number of profiles. Like in this icon, there is a rectangle and a circle in front of it, and both are joined. And similarly we are going to make a profile like that. Simply select a rectangle, draw a rectangle of 50 by 50 size, 50, 50. Now make a circle in its center. Having a radius of 15 units. Sorry, the diameter 50. Now click at this home icon. Now in order to loft this, first you have to separate both profile with the distance. For that, simply draw a line. The line represents the distance between two profiles. Enter the height 100 units, then press escape. Now type move, select this small profile, select its center point. Now move it to the top point, top end point. Now to loft that, type loft, then press enter. Select this profile first and then this, and here it is. Then press enter. For the path, you can select this line also. In the path, it would be better to look. And here it is. Our loft profile is ready. Now you can see the benefit of loft command. You can join two different profiles having different dimension, different geometry. For example, this is a rectangle and this is a circle. So this is a very good command. Now let's see in a 3D realistic view, and here it is. I hope you understand the loft command. So let's draw with another command. First change the view to 2D wireframe again. Now I am going to teach you the sweep command. The sweep command is mostly used for drawing like this spring, or you can draw pipe. For example, I am going to draw a pipe. So for that, I am drawing the isometric view. Select the home icon to change the isometric view. Now first draw a circle of diameter 20 units. Now for the pipe path, I am going to draw a line like this first, then this go to like this point. Now you can use the sweep command. Type sweep. Now select this profile first, then select the path. Now here it is. Our path is here. To see it in 3D, click on the realistic view. Now you can see I have drawn a profile that follows a path. That is the benefit of the sweep command. And hence I explained you the four commands. These four commands are really important. Let me quickly recap. This is the extrude command, where I used a single profile and give it a thickness. And this is the revolve command, where you have to draw a sectional view and then you can rotate this to up to 360 degree. Now this is the loft command, where you can join two different profiles using the loft command. There is the sweep command, which can be used to draw a circle or draw a profile that follows a path, like making a pipe. Now let's use some default options. For that, these are the some default objects that you may use every time. So for AutoCAD benefit, they provided some shapes. For example, if you want to draw a rectangle, you don't need to draw a rectangle and then extrude it. You can simply click on the box command or you can type box and specify the first point, then you can type the length as 50 comma 50, and then you can enter the length, suppose 100 units, and here it is. I draw the same rectangle here using the box command. Now let's see another command, which is the cylinder command. This is also very helpful. For that, first select the center point, then enter the diameter as 30 units. Now you can enter the height as 100 units, and here it is. Now let's see another command, which is the cone command, which is also very easy. Click at any point for the center point, then enter the radius as suppose 20, then enter an height of suppose 70 unit. Similarly, choose the sphere command, which is also very easy. Click at the same center point and enter the radius. Enter the radius as 30 units, and here it is. All the commands have the same technique to use. In AutoCAD, all the commands are based on the same. They first ask to provide some specific points to generate the object, then they ask for the dimension. Again, in this pyramid, you have to first enter the center point, then you can choose the radius. For radius, I am going to type 30 units, and then again for the another dimension, you can type height as 100 units. Now let's see what is the which command. Basically, a which command is very important in AutoCAD, because which command is mostly used to draw ribs. Ribs are mechanical supporting structures which are often used. For that, simply click on the which. You can select the first point. It is similar to making a rectangle like this. Make a rectangle of 50 by 50. And for that, I am going to type 50 by 20 actually. And then you can type the height. As you can see, this is a rib, which is a supporting structure in mechanical. Then enter the height as 50 units. Now let's see what is the torus command. The torus command is not mostly used. It is making like a donut shape, having a radius. Let me draw this. First select the center point, then you have to enter the radius of the circle. Enter the radius as suppose 100 units, and then you can enter the tube radius. The tube, you can see I am going to type only 15 units for the tube radius, and here it is. Now you have learned a lot of commands in AutoCAD. To learn more, there are two more commands. Before to teach them quickly, let's subscribe to my channel to watch more videos like this. Now let's begin to learn two more commands. The first one is the press pull. The press pull command is very helpful to produce components by clicking on just profile and then pull them. Let me show you. Click at any point, click at press pull, then select any surface that is flat. Suppose I want to extrude this profile, then I have to draw this first and then use the extrude command. And by using the press pull, you can use the press pull command to extrude this profile only. Simply click on this. Now you can see I am adding thickness to this profile. I am not adding too much. I am only adding 15 units. And here it is. You can see the difference in between. And it is a different profile. You can use the union command to join it. Now let me do it again using this profile. Maybe this profile would be better. use the press pull, and you can see I am making a ring like structure using the press pull. Enter distance as suppose 40 units, and here it is. Now the last but not least command is this command, which is not mostly used. This is a civil command which is mostly used to draw walls in a house plan. For that, click on this is called the polysolid command. Click on it. First, to draw a wall, you have to specify two dimensions. First make sure to click on the top view and make it parallel. Now first, to draw it, you have to specify two points, that is the height and the width. For the height of the wall, I am going to add about 100 units, and for the width of the wall, I am going to add 20 units. Now select the first point of the wall, then the second, then the third, and right click, then press enter. Now change the view to isometric, and you can see I have created a wall using a single command, which is very helpful, but it is mostly used for civil, so I don't recommend it to remember for mechanical students. So that's all for today. Please make sure to subscribe my channel if you want to become an expert in AutoCAD. And thank you, and have a nice day.